analyze cowboy philosopher Kinky Friedman, and from Washington, Mary Catherine Hamm, the online editor of the Washington Examiner. You know, again, it's not a matter of censorship. We don't believe in that. The freedom of expression, artistic freedom, all of that is fine. But a respect for the White House, there is where I have trouble with this kind of stuff, Mary Catherine. Am I wrong?
Well, I think in this case, you know, this endeavor seems to be so stupid as to maybe not require such an offensive as to, you know, require that it not be shown or to make a big outcry about it. I think when you're dealing with CBS and the Reagans, you had an issue of the public airwaves where the public has a little bit more leeway and a little more power in demanding things like that. But in this case, it's a private endeavor. It's so silly. It's badly timed politically. The trailer's so bad it looks like a parody that I don't think that this is going to make a whole lot of impact.
Okay. Now, if the movie is... See, the problem here is you get into the famous people deal in legality, which you can say whatever you want about President Bush or his wife or Dick Cheney or Bill O'Reilly or even Kinky Friedman, God help us, okay? But so a guy like Stone, and he's done it in the past, he can say the worst things imaginable. He can make the worst charges under the banner of being creative. And they stand because nobody can do anything about it, correct?
Well, there will certainly be falsehoods in this, and we can, of course, battle those in columns and such. But, I mean, it's going to follow in the footsteps of such great box office successes as Rendition and Stop Loss, which many people have never heard of.
So you think it's going to be a bomb?
I think it will be a bomb. The only way this movie will succeed is if McCain wins and liberals need a place to go cry in a dark theater together.
How do you see it, Kinky?
Well, hold the wedding there, Mary Catherine. This movie, it could be like Michael Moore's Fahrenheit, whatever the hell it was, you know, like that, which was seen around the world, Bill. And believe me, when people saw this, they weren't laughing like American audiences. The foreign audiences did not get the hyperbole or the facetiousness or the satire or the over-the-top nature of it. They viewed it somberly as a portrait of America.
So what do you think should be done here, if anything, with the Stone situation?
Well, the guy is he's this revisionist BS he did with the JFK thing.
Right.
This thing, George W. was a party animal. Young people live in the present. I'm an older American right now. I am too young for Medicare and too old for women to care at this point, but I personally care very much that the past is rendered accurately and that the country is not smeared overseas. And
I mean, I feel the same way, but there's nothing you can do. In fact, the more reportage we give the movie, the more people will be curious about it, Mary Catherine, the more people will go to see it. This is a worldwide broadcast now on The Factor.
Right.
You know, people all over. But there comes a point where it gets to be public opinion. Now that Stone did JFK, JFK was dead. Stone did Nixon, Nixon was dead. But Bush and his family, they're alive. And to go and to do these things, and how we know this is going to be terrible is because we've seen some of the script, and it's really, really awful.
Well, and I think to some extent his jumping the gun here and doing this at the end of the Bush administration instead of waiting for some time and acting as if he's an historian of some sort betrays the cartoonishness of the Bush hatred that goes into this. So it undercuts the idea of the film. And frankly, politically, when ostensibly he's on Obama's side, you don't want to be talking about a presidential candidate who spent his youth goofing off a little bit and doing some drugs. I'm not sure that's the way they want to go, because it doesn't equate to McCain. It doesn't make me think of McCain, who was often in Vietnam fighting.
Now, Kinky, Mary Catherine, this is going to be a bomb domestically in the United States. Do you feel that way? Do you think it's not going to get much traction?
No, I don't. I think the thing could be big, Bill. And you know, I don't like the guy, Oliver Stone, but I can see why you viscerally dislike him, because he's an anti-Bill O'Reilly. I mean, you are like a Lieutenant Columbo, kind of without the charm, you know, I mean, who's desperately, no, ruthlessly trying to get at the truth. This guy is not burdened by the truth.
No.
He can't handle the truth. He has no spiritual integrity.
No, I mean, you're about 80% there on that analysis, Kinky. I'm much more charming than Columbo ever was. But you're right in the sense that all he wants to do is make a movie so that his circle...
That's right.
Can say, oh, what a genius you are. You know, remember, this is the guy who thinks Fidel Castro is a great guy, Oliver
Right.
Stone.
Right.
All right, Mary Catherine Kinky, as always, we appreciate it.
Thank
Reality check in
Thank
a moment.
You.